Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios. Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. 25 years ago, Disney made a little family movie called The Mighty Ducks. Steve Brill wrote the movie as a little bit of an autobiography. He used to play hockey as a kid. He played for a bad team. He left hockey and then decades later picked up the game again. It's hard to believe that that kind of idea became as successful as it was and as remembered as it is now, even 25 years later. The movie cost $10 million back in 1992 and made $50 million, spun off two sequels, even had a cartoon going there for a little while, for you guys that are old enough to remember that. I barely remember it. In fact, it became even more than that, of course, because Disney head honcho Michael Eisner decided to buy, create an expansion team and call them the Mighty Ducks, of course. It was so cheesy at the time to have gone through the movies and the cartoons and then see an actual NHL team called the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim. I'm so glad they changed it to just the Ducks a number of years later. Nevertheless, it's become a very classic and remembered movie. Anyone who saw the movie back in the day remembers those characters very well today. I know I do. So with this being the silver anniversary of the Mighty Ducks film, I've decided to take current and past NHL players and try and compare them to who their Mighty Duck counterpart would be. This is going to be a really fun exercise. I hope you enjoy it. Let's go.
You really suck.
Hey, I'll decide who sucks around here.
Peter the Runt is Jared Spurgeon. At just 5'9 and 164 pounds, Jared Spurgeon is one of the shortest and lightest players in the NHL. Despite this, Spurgeon is a quick, good skating D-man who has now played close to 500 NHL games and scored a career-best 38 points in 2016-17. Dave Karp, the tough shot blocker, is Chris Russell. The former Med Hat Tiger Russell has blocked over 200 shots a season for the last four straight years. Only goalies eat more rubber than Russell, who's getting paid $5 million a season doing what he does.
Stepping out onto that ice with old copies of the Inquirer taped to your shins.
Guy Germain, the GQ ladies' man, is Tom Wilson. For the first time in my life, I had to Google NHL's hottest players. After a quick look, I decided Washington's Tom Wilson is the best current example of the Mighty Ducks' Guy Germain. Both are GQ-style dudes with a little bit of offense.
Heart attack. Great.
Les Averman, the loudmouth, is Alex Burrows. I don't want to be mean, but does any hockey fan not affiliated with the Vancouver Canucks or the Ottawa Senators like Alex Burrows? I can just imagine how many times players are telling Burrows to shut up each and every game.
Quack, 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 quack.
Connie Moreau, the only woman ever to play in men's pro hockey, is Shaunavon, Saskatchewan's own Haley Wickenheiser. Wick played in Finland and Sweden for three seasons, but she's best known, of course, for her four Olympic gold medals, racking up 51 points between 1998 and 2014.
Are we ducks or what?
Dean Portman, the brawler, is Bob Probert. Perhaps the most well-known pugilist in NHL history, Probert played nearly 1,000 NHL games, compiling almost 3,300 penalty minutes, good enough for fifth most all-time.
Somebody get a shovel and bury me right here.
Dwayne Robertson, the slick stick handler, is Pavel Datsyuk. You don't earn a name like the Magic Man in the NHL by pulling rabbits out of your hat. No, Datsyuk was a beautiful stick handler. He was quick, had a lot of moves, and he made a lot of guys look silly.
One, two, three, triple deke.
Russ Tyler, innovator of the knuckle puck, is Ryan Smith. Teammates of Smith often said Smith had a muffin shot, going slow enough that you could almost read the label on the puck. However bad his shot was, Smith had a successful 19-year career, scoring almost 400 goals.
Because we are ducks, and ducks fly together.
Luis Mendoza, the speedster, is Pavel Bure. Bure went from standing still to just flying in two strides. Bure was called the Russian Rocket because he was a dangerous goal scorer and he was impossible to catch. One of the most exciting players ever in the history of the NHL.
Cake eater.
Ken Wu, the figure skater, is Paul Coffey. Think of effortless skaters and Paul Coffey comes to mind. He just kind of glided along the frozen pond. Coffey would grind the steel on his skate blade down until it was dull. He had no edges, so it was like he was swooping as he performed those rushes.
You're not even a has-been. You're a never was.
Julia the Cat Gaffney, the only woman ever to play in the NHL, was Manon Raon when she played the first period of an exhibition game between Tampa Bay and St. Louis on September 24th, 1992. Raon was the pioneer for women's hockey in the modern age. Ironically, just like the Mighty Ducks movie, Raon's historic accomplishment occurred 25 years ago. Jesse Hall, the power forward, is Wayne Simmonds. At 6'2", 185, Scarborough, Ontario native can beat you on the scoreboard or he can beat your face. Whatever works. Simmonds has scored over 25 goals a season 5 times, and he's racked up over 100 penalty minutes in a season 5 times as well.
I told him that you were the real Minnesota Miracle Man.
Fulton Reed, the howitzer, is Zdeno Chara. At 6'9", 250 pounds, Big Z is a beast. During his prime, there was no beating Chara. He could either ragdoll you or shoot the puck so hard it would disappear. Greg Goldberg, the goalie, is Malcolm Subban. His first two NHL games, Malcolm Subban was basically giving the whole net away to his opponents. His horrendous 727 save and 581 goals against were uglier than
Margaret Thatcher naked on a cold day.
But since coming to Vegas, he looked much better, and he was actually stopping pucks before his injury.
I am Goldberg, the goalie!
Adam Banks, the sniper, is Steven Stamkos. Both are high-flying, gifted goal-scoring centermen. Both are game-breakers who can score at will, it seems. These are the type of players that bring people to the rink. Sadly, both are also injury-prone.
Just get the hell out of here.
Gordon Bombay, the coach, is Mike Sullivan, the young coach who seemed to come out of nowhere to suddenly turn a struggling team around and take them to the top. Pittsburgh was a 500 team when Sullivan took over in December of 2015. He already has 2 Stanley Cups. And Charlie Conway, the workhorse, captain, and inspirational leader, is Henrik Zetterberg. Not the most skilled player on your team, but he's your captain, and he's your everything you want in a hockey player. He's an honest, hard worker who cares about his team, his teammates, and most of all, he comes up big in big games. Like I said, a lot of very memorable characters. I think that maybe the most memorable character would be Greg Goldberg. I mean, I remember when the Ducks went to the Stanley Cup Finals in 2003. He was in the stands. CBC was interviewing him and everything. It was a lot of fun. There's even talk that they're going to have a 4th film out there and have some of the original characters now be coaches or mentors or something like that. I would totally watch that film if it came out. Of course, the other very memorable character is Charlie Conway. I remember my sisters used to watch Dawson's Creek when they were in high school. And Joshua Jackson, who played Charlie Conway, was, of course, on that show Dawson's Creek. And they would be watching it, and I would always say, Charlie Conway. Oh, look, there's Charlie Conway. And my sisters would get so mad at me and say, now it's Pacey. Awesome. Never gets tired of teasing sisters. Anyone out there who's got sisters, you can do it your entire life. It's awesome. Hey, I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this. It was a lot of fun for me to create this. What are your memories of the Mighty Ducks? Would you go see a 4th movie if it came out? Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.